Barley is cleared of any involvement with the Hayes Maitland murder just hours before marrying his childhood sweetheart, Catherine McNally. They tied the knot at St Andrew's Church, Uxbridge, now a rather attractive estate agent's, on the 18th of May 1957, honeymooned in the North Edgware Fish and Chip Shop, and moved into their new home, or in Catherine's case, her old home, Mum and Dad's. But who were these two happy, amorous people, and how did they meet? Royston Barley was born on the 22nd of January 1935 to Ada and Jerry. Jerry was something of a slippery character, big in the London crime scene, who emigrated in later years under suspicious circumstances. Ada was something in the music industry. We can see them here happily meeting again years after their divorce.
Roy's brother Jane, sorry, that was a misprint, John, and he would get up to the usual boyish pranks, such as hanging off the back of lorries when bicycling along the A40.
Meanwhile, over in the sleepy village of Hayes, a bonny blonde baby, Catherine, was born to Bella and Thomas on September the 16th, 1937.
Then two important things happened. She was discovered to have a great voice and joined the renowned choir of Mellow Lane School. Here she is in performance. Second thing, at the tender age of 15, was a snowball which hit her square on the kisser, thrown by the young Roy Barley.
And so the great romance began, unchecked by Catherine's continuing education and Roy's stint in national service, where he became a crack shot, increasing his pay packet by 2 old pennies a month, and, more significantly, where he designed a regimental badge. A taste of things to come. Now, I don't know this, but I'm pretty sure these were the happiest days of their lives, untroubled by pesky little babies, Roy starting his career in advertising and seizing the world. Young Catherine's cool late 50s look was spotted by an aspiring singer-actress who later became Doris Day. The young couple would take off into the country with brothers or mothers, but more often to the solitude of Black Park, which was the home to many a Hammer horror film, standing in for Transylvania, where the couple would listen to Nat King Cole and make out.
They try to tell us we're too young.
But let's draw a discreet veil over these proceedings. Their love of opera, which continued unabated throughout the years, may have stemmed from seeing Mario Lanza in The Great Caruso. Whilst continuing to work in advertising, he by now could draw the letter G in any font you can name. Roy also went into the house building business with his brother, who had also married to the lovely May. Then the inevitable happened. Kids. And it was the happiest times of their lives. Honestly.
I think it was in 1962 that Roy and Kath decided to move from the suburbs of London to a small, sleepy village in Berkshire called Crowthorne. As many people already knew, Crowthorne was the home of the infamous Broadmoor Prison. Their first house was a small bungalow on Edgecombe Park Drive that had no central heating, and they would have to put coats on top of the bed sheets to keep themselves warm at night. After that, they then moved to Ellis Road, just around the corner, where Roy and John's building company, Orbit Construction, built two houses next to each other. After Ellis Road, they built on a much bigger plot which they called Prior's Wood, and all the buildings to this day are still standing up.
Little Russell and little Suzanne and little Sean and little Sharon all demanded continental holidays from the moment they could speak, and it instilled in them a love of paella and swimming pools. In order to fund these extravagant holidays, Roy would work 9 to 5 in the agency, then rush home and work all night as a labourer, which is why the front door was sometimes at the back. And when the brothers started the Sindlesham Squash Club, it was Catherine and May who were hired as cheap cleaners, and very good scrubbers they were too.
Royston became very successful at his advertising work, so much so that he was promoted to creative director at the top London ad agency Lunch, Lunch and Booze, where he developed ideas for Cadbury's, Kleenex and Galaxy Counters. Building projects continued too. And in 1972, the couple acquired the fabulous residence of Fox Hollow in Windlesham, when Roy promptly switched careers to full-time golfer, spending much time at the 19th hole. Well, this is Suzanne and Russell's memories of that time. Please do not sue over any inaccuracies.
After doubling the house in size and adding a swimming pool and a dog, the family managed to squeeze in some more holidays in Mallorca, Menorca, Spain, France, Portugal and even Morocco, where we see Roy and Catherine here adopting the local costume to fit in better. Roy's jokes to sell his wife into slavery did not go down very well. In the late 1970s, they moved back to Crowthorne into Fulford Lodge, Wellingtonia Avenue, such a great location that Hitchcock used it in one of his movies. Here they sold a plot of land to a strange couple called the Bells, and Jill and John became firm friends. Now, Roy had been an artist for some time. Here's one of his Francis Bacon period in the background, one of Mum's favourites to this day. Where is it now, I wonder? But he began studying the old masters and developed into a fabulous still-life artist. Here, though, he's found a way to combine two of his loves by painting a portrait of golfing legend Tony Jacklin. I was often made to sit for a portrait, but I fidgeted and Roy got cross, so that didn't make for a very harmonious situation. Russ was spared the torture being away at boarding school. The 1970s also saw Roy's one and only culinary triumph, his legendary Chinese crispy duck, which we've all heard so much about, but no one seems to remember actually tasting it. On the contrary, it was Catherine's dinners that everyone remembers, like her whole Harrod suckling pig. She continues to be the number one cook in the family, whilst Roy is relegated to heating up Marks and Spencer dinners for two. The kids grew up and went out with unsuitable girlfriends and boyfriends. Suzanne went travelling and Russ into the refuse business. But we'd been prepared for a life in the real world and weren't so grand that we wouldn't clean up other people's crap. Meanwhile, Catherine was embarking on her own career. Following a City and Guilds bobbin lace-making course, she went on to become a world-class expert and teacher, travelling the world and publishing her own books. And I know she'd want us to mention her mentor Nina Loves It here. And in parallel, she took to the catwalk as a sometimes supermodel for her friend Jill, sometimes with her daughter making a guest appearance. What followed? Ascot, parties, parties, Ascot, champagne, the kids left home. Now it really was the happiest days of their lives.
My life, my everything. And the answer to all my dreams. You're my sun, my moon, my guiding star, my kind of wonderful. That's what you are.
Suzanne married and Dad no longer had to pay her Barclaycard bills. Nick quickly became a part of the furniture. Here's another of Roy's houses, Primrose Cottage.
They could have made two. You're all I'm living for. Your love I'll keep forevermore. You're the first.
Yeah.
You're the last.
Very well thought of.
My everything.
Russ took longer to find his soulmate, but finally met Natalie in a car park trying to steal his Mercedes. It was love at first sight. In a rush, they produced a son, then were married, and two more children came along. And the grandparents were delighted. It was the happiest days of their lives, especially as they could give the kids back.
I was asked to say a few words by Natalie. I've cut it down from 4 hours to about 10 minutes. She was born in Harrow. Well, that's a disappointment in a way. Academically, she wasn't that brilliant. She was like the rest of us, pretty ordinary, really. But she did excel at sports. And what was that?
He's clever enough to marry your son.
He's been around so long, anyone would marry him.
Town. I got a dollar and a quarter, and I'm raring to clown. But don't let nobody play me cheap. I got 50 cents more than I'm gonna keep. So let the good times roll. I'll let the good times roll. I don't care if you're young or old, just get together, let the good times roll.
Always adventurous, the couple decided to take a balloon ride over Henley. A train journey on the Orient Express. Still in love with the opera, a trip to the Roman Amphitheatre in Verona to see Puccini. He was out, unfortunately, but they enjoyed an opera performance anyway.
Here they are, in later years, leading up to their 60th anniversary, relocated to Henley-on-Thames. It really is the happiest time of their lives. This party probably won't feature any strippers, like Roy's 40th, 41st and 42nd birthday parties. Catherine's been producing even greater needlework, become an interior designer in miniature, and even self-published her own needle lace book to great success.
Roy continues to paint and play golf, not usually at the same time, despite several times threatening to give up both. Their old house, Fulford Lodge, is on the market for £6.4 billion and has been corrupted into such a fairy tale house that only the Walt Disney Corporation are considering buying it. It's almost time to wish them an anniversary toast. We just wanted to spend a minute thinking of absent friends who can't be here.
Right, Jack, Tom and Ella.
Yeah. Hello. Hello.
I'd like you to tell us your thoughts on the fact that your Nana and Grandad have been married for 60 years.
Wow, that's a long time.
I think it's amazing.
It's a shame I've only been there for 14 years of it, because I'm sure the rest of it was very good fun as well. Once I was there.
Do you think you'll ever be married that long, Ella?
No.
Ella's
going to
be a single.
Don't you hit your
sister? Yes, about Nana. She is an amazing brownie maker. I'm fabulous. Yeah. She brings the best snacks when she comes over. And she is, has a lovely, very... She has lovely hair and a good personality.
Thank you.
Well, these two have just said everything I was going to say, but... I think she's very caring, and she cares about all three of us equally, and she's obviously been a great dad to...
Dad.
She's been a great mum to my dad. And yeah.
She married the right guy.
Yeah.
For 60 years.
Thank you.
And ongoing.
Yeah, cool.
And Nana deserves a medal.
Yeah, we've already said that.
Don't put words in their mouths, Nat.
Yeah, sorry, we've already said that.
Happy birthday, Nana, and happy anniversary to you both. And Nana, please can you make us some more chocolate brownies?
Beth and Roy, we would all like to wish you a really happy evening this evening, celebrating your 80th birthday, Kath, and your 60th wedding anniversary. What an amazing achievement for you.
Woohoo!
Congratulations to you. Have a fabulous evening.
Yay! Good on ya!
All and nothing left to
bodies thinking of you. Vienna.